皆さん、こんにちは。リッチーです。And today I have got another good video for you guys. I'm going to be talking about habits I picked up in Japan. And when I was thinking of habits I had picked up, I was thinking there could be positives, there could be negatives. But honestly, most of the habits I have picked up in Japan are really positive. なんかハビットって言うと、いいと悪い意味もなんかあるけど、結構日本で僕がハビットになったことがほとんどいいことだけ。Alright, well before I tell you guys what habits I picked up, I want to give big thank you to everybody who subscribed to the channel. I really appreciate that. I also want to give big thank you to everybody who's followed my social media, checking out my other channels, listening to my music and supporting me. I really appreciate that too. And generally just giving me the best support, like it makes me so happy. Alright then, without further delay, let's get into the video.今日は5個います。じゃあ、ナンバー5。なんかもらうときに手2つ使う。Like, when somebody gives me something, I will take it with two hands instead of taking it with one. Like, if somebody gave me, like, a pen before and said, oh, here's a pen, I would just take it like that. But now, if someone gives you a pen, I would take it like that or something. Maybe not a pen. The pen's probably not the best example to use. Maybe a drink or something. Like, something that happens a lot in Japan is, There's like quite a good drinking culture. Your senpai or the person, your senior, will pour you a drink and hand it to you. And then when you get the drink, you'll take it like that. Like you won't just grab the drink with one hand. You put one hand like underneath and take the drink like that. So that's become quite a thing for me without even thinking. And I mean, I don't know whether this is a good thing. もちろんこれがいいことかわかんないけど、なんかこれよりこっちの方がなんかすごい気持ちいいよね。Like it gives you a good feeling when instead of just grabbing something with one hand and taking it,You take it with both hands and it feels like you're really taking something and you're appreciating getting that. Whether that's a gift, whether that's a business card, a drink, anything. Like if I can take it with two hands, without even thinking, I will.
なんかどっか行くと飲み物持っていく。なんかイギリスだと全然僕がカバンとかに飲み物入れないけど、日本の夏がすごい暑くて、なんか飲み物となんか現金とかないときすごい困ったから、もちろんあのスイカとか自販機使えるけど全部使えないから、なんか周りにそのなんかスイカとか使える自販機ないと、現金持ってないと飲み物持ってない、あとめっちゃ暑い、すごい困る。もうそういうタイムが少ないけど、ある。
And of course that's happened to me before, so now I just take a drink with me wherever I go, whether that's a bottle of water or something, which I never used to do, it's just something I do now, and I think it's a good thing, it's definitely good to have a drink with you.
じゃあ次はオンラインショッピングだけど、普通のオンラインショッピングじゃなくてオンラインセカンドハンドショッピング。
Like in Japan there's a few really good websites for buying things second hand. Like in the UK we have eBay and that kind of thing, but eBay for me isn't really an easy site to use. It's not the best site to navigate, and overall like you can have some bad experiences on eBay, and quite a lot of the time they are bad experiences from what I've heard. And I have purchased things on eBay before that have been great, but I have heard of the stories of things not being great and bad things happening from eBay. In Japan it's kind of like they have these apps like Rakuma and Merukadi, and they are really good apps. Like they are like I think of it like an eBay but with kind of like social media functions that you can comment and all this kind of thing. You can like and save it, and like it's just really easy to navigate.
あと僕が好きなものを日本に売ってない時多いから、その時そういうウェブサイトチェックしたらたまにある。それがすごい助かる。だからそのオンラインショッピングが、まあ、オンラインセカンドハンドショッピングがなんか楽しくなった。
Alright, on to the next one. And the next one is, I stopped withdrawing money from ATMs. Like in the UK, I would say 80% to 90% of the ATMs you'll find on the high street or whatever,are free. Like whether that's a supermarket ATM, a bank ATM, they're usually free. You do get the odd one that will charge, but most of them are free. In Japan, most of them, apart from the ones on banks and stuff, do charge. And I went through a long period of just taking out money from ones that I thought were free and they weren't, and they were charging me. So now I've kind of made it a thing not to withdraw money from ATMs unless they're like banks. So I tend to not withdraw money that much. Japan is actually quite a cash orientated country still, but recently there's some really good apps that have been made that you can use like to pay for things in shops and that, and it's just really convenient now, so I don't really find myself withdrawing money.
最後はイギリスのニュースよく見ること。なんか僕が前はあんまり、僕がなんかイギリスに行った時全然ニュースに興味なかった。なんかやっぱニュースだと悪いこと多いから僕がいつも見ないようにしてたけど、やっぱ今イギリスいないから、イギリスどうなってる知りたいからニュースチェックする。
And I find myself watching news more and more Maybe because I miss home and I want to know what's going on. Of course, like I said, I like to stay informed with things that are going on, but sometimes I don't like all the negativity, but you can't really have one, not the other. So I just tend to watch news now because yes, it is a bit negative, but I really need to know what's going on at home and just so I can stay updated. All right, well, that was my list. I really hope you enjoyed it. Those are five habits I've picked up since living in Japan. And they're not bad, right? 全然悪くないでしょ? なんかいいハビットになったね。All right then, well, I really hope you enjoyed this video and I hope you found it interesting. Also, if you did, I hope you'll leave me a like and I hope you'll check out some of my other videos. I really hope there's something you'll like. All right then, guys. Until next time, thank you so much for watching and I'll speak to you again soon. Bye. またね。